Hi guys, today I will be demonstrating how to integrate social logins using the API connector plugin made by Bubble. So what I've done is I've made the Bubble app and I have installed the plugin, and now we will be integrating the APIs. So first we'll do the Google one. As you can see, I have set up them before making this video. Okay, now I'll tell you how to I'll go through all the process and let you know about this. Now what you will be doing is, like, you will be going to the console.cloud.google.com. so I will provide all these link in the description. So you have to create an account here, and then you will be creating a project. So name this project sign up, and then create. Okay, now it's creating the project. Okay, it's done. Now we'll be going to the API section. Then we'll go to this OAuth consent screen. Okay, we will be choosing this external, then create. Now it will ask the information about your application. So I'll just copy from here. Then it's asking for a support email. I'm just putting my own. You can also give your this logo. Now it's asking for your app's domain. I'll just copy from here. Then it's also asking for a privacy policy link. I'm also giving it the same. You can give whatever you have made up in your application. It's asking for a terms of service link. You can also give that. And then we'll be giving this domain over here. That's the Bubbles domain. Okay. Now it's asking for a developer contact information. So that's also me. Give your own. Now I'll be save and continue. Okay, now you'll be setting the scopes of this app. That scopes are basically which information you want to get from Google. Now we'll be choosing email and open ID. That's pretty much it we need at the moment to log in. Now save and continue. Now we'll be adding a test user. As I will also be testing this myself. And I'll be adding it. Okay, save and continue. And now just all the summary of what you did back there. Now we'll be going back to the dashboard. See, now we'll be going to the credential section. We'll be creating the OAuth 2.2 client ID, or you can also create API keys and stuff. Doing this, it's asking for an application type. I'll choose a web application. You can just say sign up. It's asking from we don't need this. Authorize redirect URLs. Okay, now that is in the API section. Just here, it's here. You can put it this one if you want the default one. Adding, pasting it. and then create. Okay, now it gives us the client ID and client application of this application. So we'll just copy the client ID, paste it in the app ID section. We'll be choosing authentication type OAuth 2 user agent flow, and then we'll be going here, and there is the client secret. So we keep those secrets hidden from everyone, as this is a test app, so no worries. Now the ones the scope use set up there. Now like in the consent screen, now they are here, you have to write them as well here, and you have to check this and this, and these are the login dialect redirects, and these are the like access token stuff, how to get the access token links and stuff. These I will provide also the documentation that is, that basically comes from the Google documentation. I'll provide the links in the description. And now and we'll make a API call here, but basically we'll have to just ask first, sign in first, so basically you can get an access token, and then we'll basically be able to get this performing this API call. Still I have set it up. Now just collapse this and just collapse this. So now we'll be testing it in the application. First we'll check about the Google one. So basically we did that. I'll just have a made the simple design just to perform these operations. Okay, first we'll just have to also have to work this out. Design section, we'll just do this, start a workflow. So basically the workflow is sign in with a social network. Now you have to choose Google from here, and there we go. Now just be after the Google one, I'll just perform this. It will redirect us to this page. We'll just select our account, and see, it says you have it successfully initiated the OAuth 2 connection. So we just have to refresh this. Now we can make an API call now. So just expand this Google data API call and named it, and all this get and this URL link, and then I'll just reinitialize call, and there we go, we have our name, given name, picture and stuff from back we got back from Google. I'll just save this. Now if I do this again, as you can see there my name here. Now what I've done is like I've made a text box over here, and I've just written the API provider section. Wait, I'll just insert dynamic data, get data from external API here, and we'll be using name, or maybe give a name. Okay, there we go. Now we'll be doing this again. It just logs me in, and there we go, it got me this. So basically when this name is written, that means I'm logged in. So that's it for the Google one. Now I'll just go to the LinkedIn one. What I'm doing is like same LinkedIn developer and LinkedIn developers portal. I'll be creating an app over here. Just name it sign up. Says a LinkedIn page, enter your company's name. Okay, I'll just get that one. this link. And paste it here. You can also put yours as well. See, there it is. Now, it's asking for privacy policy. You can do the same what we did before. We'll just copy this again. There we go. Now, let's upload a logo. There we go. Create app. There we go, now the app is created. Now we will have to give the permissions, like we need to sign in with LinkedIn. So we'll just request access. Yes. So now it's, here we go. Now we'll be just going to the authentication section. We'll give, get our app ID from here. Now collapse this, expand this. We're testing it over here, and doing this. There we go. Now here we'll be writing the scope, highlight profile. This basically comes from the documentation, and writing these stuff. Same, the documentation stuff all here. Endpoints, user profile endpoints, stuff like that. Now I've also made the LinkedIn getting data call. It's all over here. Now what I'm doing is I'm just previewing this. I think I've missed something. Yes, I've missed it. We'll be putting a redirect URL. We could just be getting it there. The default one. Pasting it here. And update. There we go. Now the LinkedIn. See, it takes me back to the LinkedIn login. I'll just sign in. I'll be allowing this. And there we go, we have successfully initiated the OAuth connection for the API LinkedIn. So, okay. And I'll be going back now. It will be LinkedIn data call. I will just reinitialize this call. There we go, we have all the data we need from the LinkedIn. Now, just refresh this. This LinkedIn. And there we go, here's my name. Basically we signed up and it got me back my name. Okay, next we'll move on to the Facebook one. Okay, same. You have to go to the developers.facebook.com, create a application over here. Oh, it's asking for type. I'll just see this, like Facebook login, Instagram, we'll be just going with the consumer one. Then next. Okay, it's asking for an app display name. So I'm gonna sign up here. App contact email, I'm giving the Facebook one here. So basically you'll create an app. It's asking for my Facebook password. Basically you have to have a Facebook account to do this. So okay, now we'll just be setting this Facebook login. I will be doing this for web URL site. Here we go, save, continue, next. Back. Okay, now just setting this. So client OAuth login, yes. Web OAuth login, yes. Enforce HTTPS, okay. Valid redirect URLs, we'll be putting it here. There we go, it's the same one. And save changes. Okay, now we'll be going to just need the app dashboard. Okay. Actually, we need the app ID. There we go. There we have copied it. Where did it go? Collapse, expand. There we go. Just paste it here. The client token, just need the secret key. So we'll be going to the settings section, and then basic is the app ID and app secret. We'll be copying this, pasting it here. This stuff Facebook doesn't, it won't like, you need to, don't need to write scope in here for Facebook, and you'll just have to go with these stuff. These are the, all the access token addresses and stuff. You will I'll provide the link for that too. Also made the Facebook data call to get the data. Now just refresh this. Now just get the Facebook one. Okay, now it's asking me to, as this app is requesting. Okay, just continue. And there we go. Yeah, successfully initialized it. Now just this and go. And we'll reinitialize this call, and there we go, we got the name and the ID. And when we will do this, we'll refresh this and Facebook login. And there we go, there's my name. Okay, I hope you understood all that. Feel free to question around and explore more. I will provide all the links in the description that you need to, like, for the endpoints and stuff. Take care.